Now to the young teacher who saved lives in the notorious Nazi concentration camp, Auschwitz. Magda Hellinger was a 25-year-old Slovakian kindergarten teacher when she was taken from her home and sent to Auschwitz in 1942. But she wasn't just any prisoner. Her brave actions saved the lives of hundreds of her fellow Jews.
Yeah, her story has finally been told by our daughter, Maya Lee, who joins us now from Melbourne. Maya, sorry, it's a pleasure to speak to you. On the first night of Auschwitz, Magda and the other women were given soup that the Nazis said was poisoned. What did she do?
Well, she started to think, why would they bring them here into Auschwitz after 2 days in cattle cars just to poison them on the first day? So she didn't believe them. So she told the girls, I will try it, I will take a sip, I'll be okay. If I'm okay, you drink as well, because we need it. We are dehydrated, you all need it. We need to drink this.
Wow.
So she was aware that they were lying. She was aware that they were lying. Mm.
That's incredible. And she was obviously okay after tasting the soup?
It was some gamble to take, for sure.
Yeah, she said it tasted horrible, but at least it wasn't poisoned.
Yeah, wow. Sure. What a brave woman your mum was. She was given functionary roles. What does that mean? And why was your mum chosen?
Well, it all started from the beginning, actually, when these young girls, most of them were 16, 17, virtually teenagers, arrived and they were in panic, in total distress. And she was able to nurture them and was kind to them. She helped them somehow cope with this environment. And that was noticed by the student Altester, which was the room leader. And she nominated Mum to be her helper. And so that was her first step of being a student Dice, which is a room helper, to help to just bring the food from the food distribution centre, help to keep the room clean and keep an eye on the girls.
Wow. What a fascinating lady your mother was, yeah. And she saved 800 girls as well, but she saved them with a bottle of vodka. How was that?
Okay. Well, one day Joseph Mengele, who was known to be the angel of death in Auschwitz, he made a selection with 800 girls and he put them in barrack number 3. Now, once he selected them, he was no longer interested. He put them in the barrack, had a guard look after them, and that was it. And well, Mum noticed that and she saw that. She knew that the fate of these girls is going to be in the gas chamber the following day. So she decided to foil this plot. And, I mean, it sounds like something from the melodrama, but no. She and her assistant decided to do something about it. And one of the weaknesses of the German guards was alcohol. And she knew where she could find a bottle of vodka because one of the male block altisters in one of the other blocks always had a bottle there for himself. So they managed to cure it. And when they approached the guard at this block 3, they started talking to him and he told them that he was going to the Russian front the next day, and he was very unhappy, and they decided to be sorry for him, and they offered him the drink, and he kept drinking until he fell asleep. Once he fell asleep, Mum ran to the back of the block, banged on the door. She says, I'm the block altister. I want 100 girls at a time and come out with me in rows of 5 to make it look very obvious. And she took them to other barracks, called the block altister, and she said, find a room for these women. And while we do that, we'll keep bringing different group of women to different barracks until the barrack was empty. They closed the door, took away the bottle from the guard and left him there. And that was it. Wow. And the next morning, the guard was gone and no one said anything about it.
It's quite amazing the courage your mum showed at the age of 25. Mm. She was actually said to be camp leader of the experimental Block 10. Can you tell us what happened there?
Well, Block 10 was the most notorious block in Auschwitz. That's where many of the German doctors who performed horrible experiments on women, and they really made life hell for those poor girls. Mums didn't have anything to do with the experiment side of things. There were nurses for that. But she was trying to comfort those girls who were in that particular block, particularly when they came back upstairs after being experimented on, and tried to help them in any way she could.
And helped them, she did, yeah. I mean, she helped two women flee a doctor who wanted to experiment on their brains, but also she jumped in amongst the group of women marching to the gas chambers. Yes. I mean, why did she do that? I mean, how did she help them from that?
Yeah, what were the repercussions of that?
OK, well, you mentioned about the two girls which Mum saved out of the room where they were going to be taken to be experimented on, just very briefly. After she released two girls from that area, she thought that they would not be noticed and missed, but they were. So it was a very difficult time for Mum because she was going to be punished.
Yeah.
And the punishment was Sternbunker, which is a standing cell in which she had to stand with three other women in a cell for 7 nights. Now, the cell was a size of 90 centimetres by 90 centimetres. Visualise that for seven nights. And she was sort of rescued during the daytime when a group of men who were working, like also prisoners, were working in that area, and they heard that Mum was in a Sternbunker. They took pity on her and they did the work which she was supposed to do during the day while she was able to rest. And that saved her.
Despite all the horrors that she faced at Auschwitz, your mum actually met your dad at the camp. Can you tell us that story?
Yeah, I can, but do you want me to tell you about how she saved the women going to the gas chamber?
Oh, apologies.
We
want to
hear it all. Yeah.
Of course. All right. Well, what was happening, she noticed there was a big selection of women and they were all walking towards what she knew was going to be the gas chamber. The women actually didn't know because they were selected at the beginning and soon after arriving, and they were not aware of what actually was happening in the camp. So they went and they only gave them a couple of soldiers, guards, to look after them, not many, because they knew there would be no resistance at that point. So Mum saw that and she became very angry inside. She couldn't see this happening. So when the SS, the guards were not looking, there was no leadership watching, she sort of stepped in amongst the group and she told them, turn around, go back to your barracks, just go away, come back and don't look left, don't look right, just go back to your barracks, which is what they did. And it was never noticed. It was never noticed. They didn't count these women, so they just went, the other women sadly went to the gas chambers. But she did save at least 100 women at this time, and she tried that trick a few times when she thought she can get away with it.
What a woman.
Sorry, and just very quickly, your dad and your mum also met at the camp. Can you tell us that story very quickly before we go?
Okay. The guard at the front of the camp was called Mum to come over, and he was very drunk, obviously wobbly on his feet. And he said to Mum, Magda, do you have a boyfriend? And she says to him, no, I don't have a boyfriend. And he became a little bit agitated. He says, why haven't you got a boyfriend? And she says, because no one wants me. And this is a game. This is what the thing is. This is called chutzpah. She was able to play these games at times. At this stage, she was a seasoned prisoner. She knew the ins and outs of what's happening in the camp. Well, he says, okay, the first man walking past here will want you. And just at that moment, there was a group of men, a commando, coming back to the camp, to the men's camp, and the head of that group was one man. And the guard pointed to that man and he says, come here. I want you to meet this woman. And the rest is history.
What an extraordinary woman your mum was, Maya. Maya Lee's book about her mum's incredible story is called The Nazis Knew My Name. It's out now, a fascinating read. Thank you for joining us today and sharing the story of your mum.
Thank you very much. It was lovely to be with you and, appreciate it.